Hi friends, welcome to Biology Tutor. For those who did not subscribe my channel, please like, share and subscribe. Don't forget to click bell button for notifications. Today we are going to discuss about pulses. Pulses are the edible seeds of plants in the legume family Fabaceae or Leguminosae. Pulses have a high protein content, 20 to 30%, and they are known as poor man's meat. Indian Institute of Pulses Research is situated at Kanpur, Uttar Pradesh. In India, dry legume seeds with husk is called gram, but in other part of the world it is called legumes. Thal, split decorticated or dehusked grains are known as thal. Bengal gram, chickpea or chana, pigeon pea, tur or arhar, cowpea, lobia, black gram, urad, green gram, moong, lentils, masoor, peas, matar are some of the major pulses grown in India. Structure and composition of pulses. Structure. In the whole seed mass, 7 to 15% seed coat or hull, 85% cotyledons, 1 to 4% embryo. The external structures of the seed are the testa. Testa means that is a seed coat, hilum, micropyle and raphe. Composition. Pulses contain carbohydrates, mainly starches, 55 to 65%. Proteins including essential amino acids, 18 to 25%. It is much higher than cereals, and fat content is 1 to 4%. Pulses are good sources of protein, fiber, folate, calcium, iron, lysine and vitamin C. This is the chart of pulses, different types of pulses, scientific name and composition per 100 gram edible portion. Processing of pulses. Terms in milling. Milling of pulses. Removing the husk and splitting the grains into two halves. But in the case of cereals, that is, milling means removing the husk. But in the case of pulses, milling means removing the husk plus splitting the grains into two halves. Decortications or dehusking. Removal of outer husk from gram. Gota, unhusked pulse grains coming out of the roller mill is known as gota. Dust or chuni, powder obtained as byproduct from the milling operation of pulses, that is known as dust or chuni. Brocons, broken grains coming out of the roller along with the dhal, that is known as brocons. Processing of pulses involves two basic steps: seed coat or husk loosening and its removal. Second one, conversion of seed grain into splits and grinding into flour depending upon its end use. Next, home scale method of milling. Home scale method pulse milling is different in different regions. Pounding of pulses into mortar and pestle. Husk is loosened either by wet or dry method, treating the pulses with water and or oil. The pulses are then stored overnight and the next day they are sun-dried. The removal of husk is then carried out in pestle and mortar or by hand-operated stone mill. It is known as hand chakki. The husk then is separated by winnowing. That is the traditional home scale method of milling. Next, commercial scale milling of pulses. Cleaning and grading. Pulses are cleaned and size graded for yielding good quality dal with higher recovery. Two types of cleaners are normally used: reciprocating air screen cleaners and reel screen cleaners. Next, the drying of pulses. How to dry the pulses? Drying of pulses is necessary for safe storage before milling, as the pulses received at mill have high moisture content. It is done by sun drying using mechanically heated air dryers, either batch type or continuous flow type. The temperature of heated air for drying varies from 60 degrees Celsius to 120 degrees Celsius. That is all about this drying of pulses. Next is loosening, the third step, loosening of husk. Very important step in pulses milling, and it decides the total recovery and quality of milled dal. Loosening of husk is accompanied in two different ways, wet method and dry method. Pulses can be divided into two general categories according to the difficulty faced in dehusking. First category, hard to dehusk pulses, namely arhar, urad and moong. Second category, easy to dehusk pulses, namely chana, that is also known as Bengal gram, masoor, it is lentil, and field pea. Wet method. What is wet method? Pulses are soaked in water for 4 to 12 hours for steeping, mixed with red earth for 12 to 16 hours, and then sun dried to keep the moisture content about 10 to 12%. Steeping process loosens husk and facilitates easy dehusking and splitting. That is the advantage of wet method. Yield is high, but the final cooking time of dal is high in the case of wet method. Red earth is used to impart a good yellow color to the end product and to remove small patches of adhering husk due to its mild abrasive quality. That is all about wet method. Next is dry method. It produces dal that cooks faster. In this method, husk is loosened by sequence of operations such as pitting, oil smearing, conditioning or tempering, and sun drying. What is pitting? Clean and graded pulses are passed through roller dehusker, in which scratches, cracks and dents are created on hard seed coat of pulses. The pitched pulse grains are passed through the sieve cleaner to separate out the split husk and powder. That is pitting method. Next one is oil smearing. Pitted grains are mixed with about 1% oil. Linseed, mustard, rapeseed, safflower, groundnut, cashew nut, husk oil or soybean oils are used, manually or with auger mixer. Tempering. Pulses are stored for 1 to 5 days period for oil to diffuse in between the husk and cotyledons and weaken the bond and thus facilitate loosening of the adhering husk. At the end of the storage period, water is applied to the grains and stored for 12 to 14 hours. Finally, this is sun-dried for 1 to 3 days before subjecting to milling. That is all about dry method. Next, dehusking. Roller dehuskers coated with carborundum are used to dehusk the pulses. Two types of rollers are there, cylindrical and tapered. In some small dal mills, underrun disc shellers, URD or bur mills, are used for dehusking operation in place of roller mills. Depending upon the intensity of husk adhering to cotyledon, the pulse grains are passed through roller mill for 2 to 8 minutes. In case of hard to dehusk pulses like arhar, moong, urad, the number of passes through the roller machines vary between 4 to 8 times. Recovery is between 70 to 75%. easy to dehusk. Easy to dehusk pulses like Bengal gram, lentil, kesari, and peas. The number of passes vary between 2 to 4. Recovery is between 78% to 85%. Next, splitting. It involves loosening the bond between the cotyledons and splitting. For cotyledons loosening, water is applied to the dehusked pulse grain, that is known as gota, and is stored for 2 to 12 hours and later sun-dried for 4 to 8 hours. For splitting, machines like underrun disc sheller, impact machine, fatfatia, roller mill, and hitting the gota against the metal sheet at discharge side of bucket elevator are used. In this operation, the embryo attached to two cotyledons breaks away, thereby causing a loss in dhal recovery by 1.5% to 2%. Next, polishing. Polishing is done to increase consumers' appeal and is a form of value addition. Polishing gives uniform look and shine to each grain. Generally, polishing is done using soapstone, salicylic powder, oil or water. Dal is polished in different ways. Removal of powder or dust. Cylindrical rollers mounted with the rubber mats, leather strips, emery rollers are used for this purpose. Water polish. How to polish using water? Water is used. This is used for urad, chana, masoor and arhar. Buff polishing. Water and oil are used. Nylon polishing. Soapstone powder or salicylic powder is applied to the surface along with water. In South India, similar polishing is given to whole moong and urad. Telia dal. Castor oil is mixed with arhar dal to make it look glossy. The storage life of telia dal is very short and it is very popular in Gujarat. Advances in milling technology. Aspergian pea grains are most difficult to mill. Most of the researchers are on this and they are focusing to find out a new milling technology. Dry milling method of pigeon pea. Oil treatment by applying 0.5% to 2% linseed oil or any edible oil. The average yield of dal ranges from 68% to 75%. Wet milling method of pigeon pea. Water and red earth are used. In a single milling operation, about 95% of the pulses are dehusked and split. CFTRI method of PGNP milling. It overcomes the major problem of weather-dependent nature of pulse milling industry and gives high dal yield in lesser time. The process involves two passes in a dryer with 160 degrees Celsius hot air, followed by tempering for 6 hours. After the tempering, the operation is continuous, replaces sun-drying and carried out indoors. This method gives average yield of 80% dal in lesser time and lesser processing cost compared to other methods, that is the CFTRI method of pigeon pea milling. Next, Pathnagar process of pigeon pea milling. Chemical method and enzymatic treatment. Two methods are there. Chemical method. The pitted grains are treated with 10% sodium bicarbonate solution and tempered for 4 hours in shade. Dal recovery is 80% in this chemical method of Pathnagar processing. Pathnagar process of enzymatic treatment. Enzyme treatment improves digestibility of dal protein and reduces cooking time. Next, CIAE, Central Institute of Agricultural Engineering, is situated in Bhopal, मध्य प्रदेश. भोपाल इज द कैपिटल ऑफ मध्य प्रदेश. CIAE method of PGNP milling. The average recovery for PGNP is 75%. This method eliminates the use of edible oil in the milling process. Roller mill developed at CIAE for scratching are also used. Black gram milling, rough roller mill are used for scratching grains. 1-2% of oil. The average yield of dal is 70-71%. Bengal gram lentils and pea milling. Also most same method is used. They are easy to dehusk. Green gram milling. Oil and water treatments are given to the pulses. The yield of dal is poor, which varies from 62-65%. Processing of pulses before consumption. Pulses are generally consumed in the form of dal. Processing of pulses is important in improving their nutritive value. For that purpose, or we are processing pulses. The processing methods used are soaking, germination, cooking, and the last step, fermentation. Processing methods. Soaking. It is the first step in most methods of preparing pulses. Reduces anti-nutritional factors. Why to soak these pulses? In order to reduce anti-nutritional factors and reduces the oligosaccharides of the raffinose family, which are responsible for flatulence after pulse consumption. Next, it also helps to reduce the amount of phytic acid in pulses. Phytic acid will bind with micronutrients and it will cause malnutrition. Fermentation increases their digestibility, palatability, availability of essential amino acids and nutritive value. For what purpose we are doing this fermentation? Fermentation used to increase the essential amino acids and nutritive value. Examples of fermented products are idli and dosa. Germination. Sprouting causes partial breakdown of starch and proteins and contributes to the better digestibility. It also improves flavor of the legume. Sprouted legumes can be used as ready-to-use marketable product. Sprouting causes hydrolysis of the oligosaccharides, also responsible for causing flatulence of legumes. For this purpose, we are germinating these pulses. Puffing. Puffing and toasting of pulses is practiced all over the country. These products are traditionally used as snacks. It makes dal lighter with porous structure, making it soft to eat. The increase in size to 1.5 to 2 times of its original size. Bengal gram and peas are best suitable for puffing. The grains are first soaked in water for short duration, 1 to 3 minutes. Mixed with sand, heated to 250 degrees Celsius and toasted for 15 to 25 seconds with agitation. After sieving off the sand, the grains are dehusked between a hot plate and a fast rotating rough roller. The yield of puffed product is about 65-70% by weight. That is all about puffing. Next product from pulses. Bisan manufacture. Bisan is made from chana dal, Bengal gram. Its production involves 3 major steps: size reduction, sieving, and packaging. Bisan is made in rural areas and at home scale level in bur mills, atta chakki. Some manufacturers employ pulverizers, hammer mill, along with reel sieves. Recovery of bisan is 98%. Next, puppet. puppet flower is made by combining few pulses flowers like urad, moong, etc. In some puppet flowers, gram pulse is also added. The puppet flower along with spices like black pepper, jeera, soda and salt is tightly kneaded with water and thus rolled tightly on chaklabilan. CFTRI has developed a puppet mill, chunibusi, as animal feed. What is chunibusi? Chunibusi is a mixture of broken dal and husk obtained during milling of pulses. It is not fit for human consumption, so we will use this as animal and poultry feed. Thank you. If you like this channel, please share and subscribe. Don't forget to click the bell button to get notifications.